you have already undertaken some unconventional initiatives in limiting the groundwater economy, which is the foundation of limited agriculture. Although the government has enthusiastically made common cause with the farming communities in undertaking decentralized rainwater harvesting and groundwater recharge. By adopting an aggressive recharge strategy that has contributed significantly in stabilizing the groundwater levels and even reversing of the drain of groundwater pollution, the Saurashtra region of Gujarat has become a role model for other states to become easy how to demystify and try to understand. This is the, all of you know, I am typically Gujarat state having 4 regions. The first and the Saurashtra region is touching the district and region as well. Saurashtra region is this Uttar part. And then another part of Gujarat shaded in Metro line and the Pubic line of the southern part. Basically, this movement had started as a vast movement that is leading to the late 1980s. And subsequently, the Gujarat government made strong support to communities and NGOs to respond to this work and participate in both under the Sarkari Jal Sanchay Yojana. The scheme best performing Saurashtra region as more of other speakers have already said, in part of the state as a whole, by the December 2011, nearly 500,000 structures were constructed under the oversight of the Water Resources Department of the Government of Gujarat. Maintained, which included nearly 113,000 check dams, 56,000 polygons, 40,000 farm homes, besides 62,000.
I think there's a paper out there, paper number 49, which has all the information, much more detail.
Yes. So I just request you, if you would get to the single critical learnings that you have achieved, if you would focus on that.
There are three slides of it, and there are five points. So, in this basically, once we look at the hydroclimatic and critical conditions of Gujarat, these are the region specific conditions, region specific region they are given here. North Gujarat is extent in basic area to semi-arid climate, groundwater is the next specific irrigation here. The ecosystem is overexploited by enterprising farmers and is highly developed dairy and dairy operators. In South Gujarat, this is basically inland water because why this has to expand in reference to the requirement of recharge, this is in reference to understanding the hydroclimatic conditions. South Gujarat is inland water inland part of Gujarat, large area and canal irrigation, such as Mahi, Utai, Kata, Park, Kanyan, Jodhpur, and Kata, Jodhpur, and condemn the use of groundwater and canal water to farming initiatives already in place. Saurashtra is groundwater the main use of water supply and irrigation, and part of it for poor sporadically, open level and some less use of irrigation, and agriculture is mostly dependent on monsoon. The cost for kharif crop. So here basically the monsoon directly affects the kharif crop and following rabi and summer crop. So that's the region most affected by monsoon rainfall. And that's also similar conditions prevail, but there we have got micro aquifers and there are two also. Now this is at the height of year, this yellow report is the rural extensive set of aquifers. Then we have got the Saurashtra peninsula area, where major part is decorated from like the green color ornamentation. In that area we have got the muscle lakes and also the part of the crop and South Gujarat also is more of part of. Now demystification, what are the forces responsible for stabilizing the groundwater levels and even reversing the trend of groundwater pollution in semi-arid and Saurashtra region in Gujarat? We have tried to see the effect of various drivers to Gujarat, either the succession of monsoons or the Saurashtra irrigation project, or we have things farmers and government of Gujarat have done, and then each driver we have tried to manage. This paper attempts to unlock the secret of Saurashtra groundwater irrigation during the recent years. If the nature is caused by the acts of God, like favorable monsoons, it is not critical, this is policy in place. However, the policy, common policy drivers behind the level are there, behind the Saurashtra people are there, then it acquires great significance for the nations and offers to other states in the country about how to keep starting the effective buildup of groundwater resources to irrigate and send their communities. Now, the hypothesis here made is number one, the rainfall increase contribution, like if there has been an increasing rainfall, this will contribute to even increase in the availability of water across all the regions. The second part is if there is increased availability to canal irrigation system, which is a major driver of use of groundwater resources, then we do not expect to see large impacts in North Gujarat, Saurashtra and which is not yet canal irrigated area. Then decentralized groundwater recharge activities which are concentrated mostly in Saurashtra and to a lesser extent in North Gujarat and Kutch, hence its effect should be minimal only in these regions. This implies that groundwater recharge activities which are concentrated mostly in Saurashtra, North Gujarat and Kutch will affect the region specific impact on groundwater recharge if they form prominent driver of recharge. Now let us look at the hypothesis. This is the hypothesis which was made, considering the various drivers for recharge and the regions that will be affected. Then we see if the rainfall is very good, then it will affect all the regions in a normal manner. But canals, we see that there is a very high canal density in South Gujarat. So if the availability of water from SSP or ANS was increased, then it would be a functional impact of increasing the groundwater resources in South Gujarat region. In fact, we have got many states which get less affected. North Gujarat has got moderate and Saurashtra also has got lesser extent. Slowly it takes and forms similarly, and then the irrigation return flows, they are dependent on the canals which we have. And then same with the conversion. So as I said, the irrigation conversion tanks have been implemented to the maximum extent in Saurashtra region. We expect in our analysis to see the maximum impact in Saurashtra region and to a lesser extent in North Gujarat and Kutch. Now if we look at the groundwater recharge in Gujarat, between 2000 and 2002 period from monsoon and non-monsoon sources, and what they are able to see is that there is together increase in recharge from various sources. But what is important is if you look at the recharge from other sources, this is following the second in monsoon, then what we find in Saurashtra, we find that the recharge was of the order of 460 million cubic meters, that has increased to 900 million cubic meters, that has been a 100% increase. Now this kind of increase is not visible in any of the other regions. In North Gujarat, it's about 100 MCM only, that's about 10%. In Kutch area, it's about 20%. South Gujarat also is about 15%. In like this, what we see only in the Saurashtra area, which is from other sources, has increased by 100%. Now, how did this happen? Then in other regions, of course, we see similar things. Now, this shows the disaggregated region of contribution of different sources of groundwater recharge during monsoon. As this very clearly reflects that in Saurashtra region, there has been a very significant increase. This component of recharge. And now what are the basic factors responsible for it? That analysis has been done. So what we see in part of Gujarat, especially the government leaders of Saurashtra and North Gujarat, and we see the bottom normal rainfall during the recent year, this has been shown by various authors already. Except during 2002, when almost all of India experienced shortfall in rainfall precipitation, Gujarat also faced an overall rainfall. However, the government leaders of Saurashtra and North Gujarat had above a median normal rainfall. However, southern part of the drought hit. In this condition of rainfall and we see that after the year 2000, there has been a surplus rainfall after some very good moment, except 2002 where South Gujarat was in the low normal rainfall. So the total groundwater recharge from rainfall has increased to the extent of 12% in the state as a whole, from 10,600 MCM to 11,900 MCM. And the region-wide variation is 8%. The increase 8% is Saurashtra, 27% in Kutch, 17% in North Gujarat, and 10% in South Gujarat. But if we see the contribution from other sources, because during the monsoon season there are two contributors, one is the rainfall and the other is the storage structure. Storage structures include the drainage and water quality tanks. So if we look at that figure, what we find is that the monsoon recharge has increased by 30% in 2007 compared to 2002. This increase, it is 7% in South Gujarat, 11% in North Gujarat, and 92% in Saurashtra region. So after 2003 drought, monsoon at the time was part of India, except 2009. And yet, in the total Saurashtra region, which has experienced rapid buildup of groundwater resources during the years. Now, Water levels and groundwater pollution, in spite of recent rainfall.